outside my window. I feel it in my soul.
My soul.
The stars were burning so bright. The sun was out till midnight. I say we lose
right outdoors,
control.
Got a table nature pictures. We'd like to say we run what they don't. So we want to give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run. When it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. We're going to have products for you to get out there. No one better sitting on your bike, not training.
This is going to be the best day of my life.
Yeah, I'm married. Does it matter? You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy, so...
Another reason more people stay with State Farm. Get to a better state.
If it's important to you, it's important to us.
Look.
So we're renewing our commitment. For modern moms, we want the very best.
One shot.
Discerning dads.
One opportunity.
Who like to keep things real.
He sees everything you ever wanted.
Who know how they like to be. Our loyal fans,
you
who like to keep things fresh. And our newest followers, who always have the planet in mind. It starts with a passion for our food and a simple belief. The simpler, the better.
Running outdoors, you got to take what nature gives you. We'd like to say we run when they don't. So we want to give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run. When it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. We're going to have products for you to get out there. You don't get better sitting on your butt not training. You got to get out there and run.
At Under Armour, it's always about premium textiles. They need to perform, they need to be the best. The merging of hybrid textiles with naturals and new seaming and bonding and super sleek, modern, fast, futuristic designs, that's where we are really going to turn it up a notch. If you look good and you feel good, you're going to perform better.
Yeah, I'm married. Does it matter? You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy, so...
Another reason more people stay with State Farm. Get to a better state.
If it's important to you.
Running out.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Mic's on! First down!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Running outdoors, you got to take what nature gives you. We'd like to say we run when they don't. So we want to give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run. When it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. We're going to have products for you to get out there. You don't get better sitting on your butt not training. You got to get out there and run.
At Under Armour, it's always about premium textiles. They need to perform, they need to be the best. the merging of hybrid textiles with naturals and new seaming and bonding and super sleek, modern, fast, futuristic designs. That's where we are really going to turn it up a notch. If you look good and you feel good, you're going to perform better.
Winter Regional Healthcare Center is proud to sponsor coverage of Winter Warriors and...
Testing 1, 2, all right, good afternoon, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are here in Pierce, South Dakota, with the Sweet 16 between Cool Creek and Chamberlain. We want to apologize for starting on time. Here we got Cool Creek and Chamberlain. They're doing the start lineup right now. Start lineup for Cool Creek. We got Dason Colas. He's a 5'9 junior. Luke Wells, junior. He's a 6'2 freshman. Also, we have number 20, Jaden McBride, a 5'10 sophomore. Oh, they're going back and forth here. Number 25 for Cole Creek, Josiah Bluearm, 6'3 junior. And then number 23, I believe, Joel Sazu, the third. He's a 6'1 junior. Head coach for Cole Creek is Billy Joel Sazu, assisted by Luke Wells, senior, and Quentin McBride. Starting for Chamberlain is number 2, Tegan Breed. He's a 5'9 senior. Number 24, Seth Fries. He's a 6'1 senior. Number 33, I believe, Rich Marone. He's a 6'3 senior. Number 20, Riggs Preeb. He's a 5'10 junior. And also number 34, Dodge Knipley for Chamberlain. Head coach for Chamberlain is Adam Nelson. And I believe at this time, ladies and gentlemen, we'll start with the... So we'll go with a quick commercial break while I sing.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Running outdoors, you gotta take what nature gives you. We'd like to say we run when they don't. So we wanna give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run, when it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. We're gonna have products for you to get out there. You don't get better sitting on your butt not training. You gotta get out there and run.
At Under Armour, it's always about premium textiles. They need to perform, they need to be the best. The merging of hybrid textiles with naturals and new seaming and bonding and super sleek, modern, fast, futuristic designs, that's where we are really gonna turn it up a notch. If you look good and you feel good, you're gonna perform better.
Winter Regional Healthcare Center is proud to sponsor coverage of Winter Warriors and Lady Warriors athletics and activities on Winter Warriors Live. Best of luck in today's event. Here at Winter Regional Healthcare, we are committed to professional care with a personal touch at our locally owned hospital, clinic, and long-term care facility. For more information on services we provide, check out our website at winterregional.org. Winter Regional, proud to support the student athletes and activities. Honored to serve the families of South Central South Dakota and our community for over 65 years. Remember, professional care with the personal touch at Winter Regional Healthcare.
Where will you find? All right, and we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go with the Sweet 16, but here it's more like a Region 6A championship. You know, who would have thought Crow Creek and Chamberlain would have been playing in the first ever Sweet 16, but it's happening now, ladies and gentlemen. It is happening now. Before we start, I want to thank St. Francis Indian School for letting us use the internet stream, and here we go. And right off, we have a fall, I believe, on Colas. That's his first. 3 points by number 24 for Chamberlain. Seth Freeze. Now 3-0. Colas over to Blue Arm, over to Luke. Luke Wiles with the give it to Colas. Colas will put it up for two. 2 points. Jason Colas. And 2 points for Chamberlain, number 33, Rich Marone. 5-2 is the score. 5-2. Chamberlain over Crow Creek. Right off in this first quarter. Joel Sazu with the shot. It's up. No good. Rebound by Seth Freeze. And he'll break it down. And he'll shoot it. He is blocked. Key Chakpa by Joel Sazu. Shots up by number two for Chamberlain. Preeb. Brings the score 7-2. Chamberlain.
Jesse, it looks like that... Crow Creek's going to have to work on their boards a little more to have success tonight, buddy.
Yeah, it looks like it is. There. Luke Wells with the shot. He gets fouled. Want to join in Mr. Brian C. Once again, want to thank him for letting us use the internet stream.
It's my pleasure, sir. That's what when I went to my superintendent, he said that's what we do for our relatives.
Uh-huh. Ooh, even a white guy said that. At the line here, Luke Wells. First one's up, no good.
Radio show back home. We got the Indian and the white guy.
Luke Wells with the second free throw. It's up, and that's no good. Rebound by number 33 for Chamberlain. Marone.
A little pregame jitters right now going on, looks like almost.
Shots up by number 34, Knippling, it's no good. Bucket stays here. Chamberlain basketball. Freeze with the ball, he'll give it to number 20. Preeb, over to Preeb. First time I said that, Preeb to Preeb. Preeb with the shot up, no good. Rebound by Colas. And it's stolen. And 2 points by Chamberlain, number 33, Rich Marone.
Looks like a little push there.
Brings the score 9-2. I think that's why I'm on here. Otherwise, I'd be chewing out rest right now. Stays here, Crow Creek basketball. You know, I've been doing radio. I did a powwow, basketball games, and now I'm on the internet stream. So I gotta scratch this off the bucket list here. It's 9-2, 5:40 left to go in quarter number one. McBride with the ball. He'll give it a Blue Arm over to Colas.
You should about have your bucket list except for ESPN, I suppose. Huh?
Colas, which is that no good? Knippling gets the rebound. Seth Freeze with the shot, it's up, and he gets fouled.
Sazu.
That's his first.
This is Rich Crowe-Eagle. This is his biggest worry in this game tonight was the size of Chamberlain and how Crow Creek was going to match up with him and keep up with him shooting.
Set threes at the line. First shot is up and good. Two for two for Seth Fries. Bring the score 11 to 2. Chamberlain. 5:20. Wells with the ball. He'll lay it up. And 2 points for Luke Wells. 11 to 4. Pree with the ball. He'll stolen. Stolen here by Jason Colas. Colas with the ball. He'll give it to Sazu. Sazu will take the shot. It's up. No good. Rebound by number 34 for Chamberlain. Knipling. 4:38 left to go in quarter number one. Still 11 to 4. Chamberlain over Crow Creek. Freeze with the shot. It's up. No good. Rebound by Jaden McBride. He'll give it to Colas. Colas over to Sazu. Sazu with the, looks like a pass. And that pass was no good. Chamberlain basketball. We got a sub coming in for Chamberlain. Number one, Carson Powers. Carson Powers. Powers is a 5'10 junior. Powers with the ball. We'll give it a freeze over to Knipling. Dupree. Dupree will put it up. And 2 points. 13 to 4. Scores down 13 to 4. Chamberlain over Crow Creek. 4 minutes to go in quarter number one. Colas with the ball. He'll give it to Luke Wells. Luke Wells with a shot. It's up and 3 points by Luke Wells. That'll bring the score 13 to 7. 3:43 left to go in quarter number one. Powers, give it a Preve. Preve on top of the key. He'll get over to Marone, over to Freeze. Freeze will put it up and 2 points. Seth Freeze. 15-7. Scores down 15-7. Colas over to Josiah Bluearm. Then over to Jaden McBride. McBride back to Colas. Colas will drive it, dish it out to Sazu, then back over to Luke Wells. Luke Wells and McBride. 10 seconds on the shot clock. McBride will put it up. No good. Rebound by number 34, Knipling. Preeb. 2 points. And we got a timeout on the floor. 17-7. Score is 17-7, 2:49 in the first quarter.
We'll go to commercial for a second here. All right.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
All right, and we are back, ladies and gentlemen. It's 2:49 left to go in quarter number one. Chamberlain 17, Crow Creek 7. This is the Sweet 16. It looks like the 6A Regional Championship, but this is the Sweet 16. Who would have thought Chamberlain and Crow Creek matching up to get it to state?
Well, unfortunately, St. Francis lost to Pine Ridge. If we'd have won, we'd have played Little Wing tonight.
2 points by Joel Sazu. I know Pine Ridge is playing. We'll figure that out. Mount Vernon Plankinton. We have a foul on the floor here. Looks like Joe Sazu, the third. That's his second.
They need him all night tonight. He's going to have to be careful from here on.
Yes, they do. Falls on the floor here. Chamberlain basketball. Powers. To Knipling, to Freeze. Freeze will put it up and 2 points. Seth Freeze. I believe Freeze has 9 points now.
9 points.
Luke Wells will put the shot up and 2 points. Luke Wells. 19-11. 19-11, 146 left to go in quarter number one here in Pierce, South Dakota, Riggs High School. Shots up, no good by Preeb. JD McBride with the rebound. He'll give it to Sazu. Sazu will try the three and good. Joel Sazu, the third, with the three. 19-14. It is now 19-14. Coke Creek slowly making a way back here, but Seth Freeze at two more points here for Seth Freeze. 21-14. Chamberlain over Crow Creek. We have 1 minute left to go in quarter number one. Luke Wells with the ball. He'll put it up. And look like it was, he turned the ball over. We got a sub coming in for Crow Creek, number 22, Rashawn Pease. Rashawn Pease is a 6'1 senior. So here we go, 48 seconds. Shot is up and no good. Rebound by Luke Wells. Rashawn Pease will give it to Joe Sazu, the third. He'll try another three and almost. Kellen St. John also subbed in. Luke Wells with the shot. That's up, no good. Rebound by Knipling. And it looks like they're going to go with one shot here. 26, 25 seconds left to go in quarter number one. 21-14. 21-14.
One touchdown game.
Keegan Pree will just walk the ball here. Give it to Knipling. Over to Powers. Back to Preeb, and it's stolen. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Nice pass. They got to count that.
Count the bucket.
They counted the bucket. Bucket is good. Goaltending. That's the end of quarter number one, 21-16. 21-16, we've got a good game going on here. And
we'll have a commercial break here. Listen to a few more sponsors. Be back in 1 minute.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Running outdoors, you got to take what nature gives you. We'd like to say we run when they don't. So we want to give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run. When it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. We're going to have products for you to get out there. You don't get better sitting on your butt not training. You got to get out there and run.
At Under Armour, it's always about premium textiles. They need to perform, they need to be the best. The merging of hybrid textiles with naturals and new seaming and bonding and super sleek, modern, fast, futuristic designs, that's where we are really going to turn it up a notch. If you look good and you feel good, you're going to perform better.
We are back to scores now, 21-19. We had a last early three-point shot by Colas. That was good. Seth Freeze will add total 2 more points to his score. Bring his score 23-19. Seth Freeze now has 13 points. kind of playing like me back in the day. That's turnover here by St. John. Seth Fries will try a three. It's up. No good. Rebound by Kellen St. John. Kellen St. John is a 5'8 senior. Colas over to Sazu. Back to Colas. And he gets fouled on the floor. Ball number two for Chamberlain. Tegan Pree. I believe that is his first. We got a sub coming in. Back for Crow Creek, Jaden McBride. And we got a timeout on the floor. Earlier, like we said, want to congratulate St. Thomas More on their win over Aberdeen Roncalli earlier today. Also, I believe T Area beat Little Wound.
83 by about 20 it was.
It was about I know about Pine Ridge and
Mount Vernon Plankinton.
So if anyone who is tuned in can let me know, keep me updated on some of the scores. I know we got a lot of people here. This is kind of cool, you know. I like I've been on the radio, but this is like I'm on TV.
We'll put the camera on you at halftime.
Yeah, yeah. We'll get a camera. We'll get a sock, and we'll do a little bit of halftime. Our first half analysis. Here we go. 6:53 left to go in first half. Rayshawn Pease almost traveled. We'll give it to Luke. But wow. Luke will travel, I guess. That's all I can say is I guess.
Luke's been playing above his age right now, and I hope he continues that for the rest of the night.
Yeah, he's. This is something that we've been looking for Luke Wells all season. You know, he's been off and on, and this is the game where we need him the most, and he's putting in work here. Fall on number 20 for Chamberlain. Preeb. That's Preeb's first. Rayshawn Pease will give it to McBride. McBride with the ball. He'll give it to St. John. Over to Luke Wells. Luke Wells will fake the three. Give it to Colas. Colas with the ball. Still, he'll give it to Rayshawn Pease. Rayshawn will give it to Luke. Over to St. John. St. John with the shot, it's up, no good. And it was rebound here by number two, Preeb. Tegan Preeb, who has the ball. He'll give it to Freeze, to Marone. Either one back and forth. Too fast for me, to Preeb with two. It's now 25-19. Chamberlain over Crow Creek, 5:45 in the first half. McBride with the ball. Jaden McBride. He'll go one way. He'll fake the three. He'll give it to Colas. Colas to try the three. It's up. No good. Rebound by number 20. Riggs. Riggs Pree with the rebound. Seth Fries now with the ball. He'll give it to number 34 for Chamberlain. Dodge Kniplin, and he'll put it in for two. 27-19.
Big Crow Creek just needs to keep being patient and really attack the boards, and that's going to keep them in this game.
Colas with the ball. He'll give it to St. John. St. John will try the three. It's up and good. 3 points. Kellen St. John. 27-22, 4:55 left to go in the first half. 27-22. Chamberlain with a 5-point lead. Freeze with the ball. He'll give it to number 20, Riggs Preeb. Riggs over to Kniplin. Oh, no, that's 33, Rich Marone. Rich Marone for two. He'll take the score back up to 7, 29-22, 4:30 left to go. Luke Wells will try the three, and it's good.
I can remember when you guys came to St. Francis, they were deadly the first quarter on the threes. If they can get that way, this can be a game.
Yeah. Rebound here by Rayshawn Pease. That's how we were against them earlier. Earlier in the season, we were launching threes and they weren't going in. And what's going on here? It looked like a rebound substitution timeout kind of thing. I don't know how to explain that. I think that's a first time for me. But hey, there's a first time for everything. But we got subs coming in. Josiah Blue Arm for Crow Creek. Seth Freeze. He'll try the shot up, and he is on fire, ladies and gentlemen. He is on fire. That's 15 points now for Seth Freeze.
Half their points right now.
31-25 is the score, 31-25. St. John with the ball. He'll give it to Sazu. Sazu over to McBride. McBride back to Sazu. Over to Blue Arm. Blue Arm with the ball. He's not a guard, but he'll try it anyway. Looks like an offensive foul. Offensive foul on number 25 for Coal Creek. Josiah Blue Arm. I believe that's his first.
Yep.
Team foul number 4 for Coal Creek. 3:11 left to go in the first half. 31-25. Chamberlain over Coal Creek here in Pier.
There's a charger. Oh, my Lord.
They ain't calling it. Kinchakba.
Hey. The extra effort there by the Crow Creek Chieftains got the ball back for me after the no call.
I guess they're letting them play. I always wanted to say that. You know, I always hear radio people, ESPN. I guess they're letting them play. Sazu, give it to St. John. St. John with the pass to Rayshon Pease. He'll put it up. No good.
Frustration foul.
It looked like he got fouled, but I ain't going to say nothing. Although I think I just did. Rayshon Pease with the foul. That's Rayshon's first. Team foul number 5. 2:43 left to go. 31-25. We got a good first half already going. Seth Freeze is keeping that Chamberlain lead. And he's going to keep on shooting. Up, no good. Blue Arm with the rebound for Coal Creek. Give it to St. John over to McBride. McBride to Luke Wells. Luke Wells will try the three. It's up, no good. Rebound. Offensive rebound by McBride. And he gets fouled.
That's what you need to get right there a lot.
He is fouled here by number 20. Riggs Preeb. That's his second sub coming in for Chamberlain. Number 1, Carson Powers. We got an update here. Pine Ridge, 36-26. Pine Ridge, 3:12 left to go in quarter number 2 over Plankinton. Seth Freeze will try the 3. Up, no good. And he gets... We'll give him the offensive rebound, but then we'll give him another turnover. How's that? Coal Creek basketball. I don't know. I mean, I don't know if that's even stats, but if he didn't get the rebound, you know, and turned it over, Chamberlain might have still had the ball. Does that make sense? No good here by Luke Wells. Knippling with the rebound for Chamberlain. Seth Freeze now with the ball. He'll give it to number 33. Mitch Marone over to Tegan Preeb. Tegan to Powers. Powers to Knippling to Freeze. Freeze is going to try another 3. And finally, 3 points for Seth Freeze, 34-25. St. John with the shot. That's up, no good. And we got a rebound by Chamberlain, number 2. Tegan Preeb. 1:03 left to go in the first half. It's 34-25. Chamberlain over Coal Creek. 34-25. And we got ball stolen here by Luke Wells. And he gets fouled. Fouled by number 33 for Chamberlain, Rich Marone.
Score ahead at the half, 29-21. Tri-Valley was over Clark Willow Lake.
Tri-Valley over Clark, 29-21.
At the half.
At the half. Luke Wells here at the line to shoot two. First one's up and no good. That's his third free throw he missed. Colas coming back in for Crow Creek.
Right now, Crow Creek 0 for 3 from the line, the 2 for 2 on Chamberlain.
0 for 3. All of those are by Luke. And finally, 1 for 2.
We broke the karma on him. Broke the ice for him.
We are good to go now. 48 seconds, 34-26. Seth Freeze over 2, number 34. Back over to Powers. Powers over to Marone. Back to number 2. He'll put the shot up and 3 points by Keegan Freeb. It's now 37-26. I don't think they would call that a block because he kind of turned it over and he blocked it. But whatever. 14 seconds. 37-26. Seth Freeze with the ball. And he'll keep it. And he'll over to number 2. Preeb will try the free throw shot. It's up no good. Sazu with the rebound. He'll give it to Colas. And that is the halftime. Chamberlain 37. Pro Creek 26. So once again, I want to thank St. Francis Indian School for letting us use this internet stream. I know we have a lot of people who are...
Running outdoors, you gotta take what nature gives you. We'd like to say we run when they don't. So we wanna give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run, when it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. We're gonna have products for you to get out there. You don't get better sitting on your butt not training. You gotta get out there and run.
At Under Armour, it's always about premium textiles. They need to perform, they need to be the best. The merging of hybrid textiles with naturals and new seaming and bonding and super sleek, modern, fast, futuristic designs, that's where we are really going to turn it up a notch. If you look good and you feel good, you're going to perform better.
Yeah, I'm married. Doesn't matter. You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy, so...
Another reason more people stay with State Farm. Get to a better state.
If it's important to you, it's important to us. So we're renewing our commitment for modern moms who want the very best, discerning dads who like to keep things real, the lovers of meat who know how they like their beef, our loyal fans who like to keep things fresh, and our newest followers who always have the planet in mind. It starts with a passion for our food and a simple belief: the simpler, the better.
Running outdoors, you gotta take what nature gives you. We'd like to say we run when they don't. So we wanna give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run, when it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. we're going to have products for you to get out there. You don't get better sitting on your butt not training. You got to get out there and run.
At Under Armour, it's always about premium textiles. They need to perform, they need to be the best. The merging of hybrid textiles with naturals and new seaming and bonding and super sleek, modern, fast, futuristic designs, that's where we are really going to turn it up a notch. If you look good and you feel good, you're going to perform better.
Yeah, I'm married. Does it matter? You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy, so...
Another reason more people stay with State Farm. Get to a better state.
If it's important to you, it's important to us. So we're renewing our commitment for modern moms who want the very best, discerning dads who like to keep things real, the lovers of meat who know how they like their beef, our loyal fans who like to keep things fresh, and our newest followers who always have the planet in mind. It starts with a passion for our food and a simple belief: the simpler, the better.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Running outdoors, you gotta take what nature gives you. We'd like to say we run when they don't. So we wanna give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run, when it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. We're gonna have products for you to get out there. You don't get better sitting on your butt not training. You gotta get out there and run.
At Under Armour, it's always about premium textiles. They need to perform, they need to be the best. The merging of hybrid textiles with naturals and new seaming and bonding and super sleek, modern, fast, futuristic designs, that's where we are really going to turn it up a notch. If you look good and you feel good, you're going to perform better.
Winter Regional Healthcare Center is proud to sponsor coverage of Winter Warriors and Lady Warriors athletics and activities on Winter Warriors Live. Best of luck in today's event. Here at Winter Regional Healthcare, we are committed to professional care with a personal touch at our locally owned hospital, clinic, and long-term care facility. For more information on services we provide, check out our website at winterregional.org. Winter Regional, proud to support the student athletes and activities. Honored to serve the families of South Central South Dakota and our community for over 65 years. Remember, professional care with the personal touch at Winter Regional Healthcare.
Where will you find Black Hills State University graduates? Everywhere! Locally, nationally, and internationally. Black Hills State University is where community leaders are inspired, where future teachers are prepared, where global connections lead to business connections, and where underground research is changing the way we understand the universe. Visit bhsu.edu and enroll now at Black Hills State University, where you can earn your degree affordably and with campuses in Spearfish and Rapid City. Stay in the beautiful Black Hills. Where does your future begin? At Black Hills State University. Where anything is possible.
Computers and More, located at 660 West 2nd Street, is obviously your computer sales and repair business in Winter. The More is so much other than you can imagine. We are your local outlet for Winter Warrior sports apparel. We do screen printing and embroidery for your purple and gold attire. Stop in and check out all our gear on hand for you to wear to the next game. Call us at 842-9057 for an appointment to see how we can design your company logo on all types of clothing. And remember, thanks for keeping it local.
If it's important to you, it's important to us. So we're renewing our commitment for modern moms who want the very best, discerning dads who like to keep things real, the lovers of meat who know how they like their beef, our loyal fans who like to keep things fresh, and our newest followers who always have the planet in mind. It starts with a passion for our food and a simple belief. The simpler, the better.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
We had a pretty good half here. Well, Seth Fries had a pretty good half. He had 18 points. Seth Fries had 18 points. I believe Rich Marone had 6. Dodge Knipling had 2. And Tegan Preeb had 11 for Chamberlain. And for Crow Creek, Luke Wells had 11 points. In the first half, Dason Colas had 10. And Joel Sazu had 3. So we got about 16 seconds left. Again, I know the school here, St. Francis Indy School, had to pay some bills. So that's why we're going through all the sponsors and everything. And
make sure you do some of that too. When you get a chance, we'll do some of these.
So here I want to thank everyone for tuning in. I know we got a lot of listeners here. Joe Wells, Billy Jean, and if you're tuning in here through the internet stream, please let me know. I know we got people watching it on the living room, like I'm on ESPN or something. But here we go, second half here, 37-26. Seth Fries, we need to cool that guy off. Offensive foul by Chamberlain, and they'll reset the shot clock. They'll give it to number 34, Dodge Knipling. We'll give it to Tegan Pree. Tegan Pree will put it up in 2 points. It's now 39-26. Luke Wells with the ball. He'll put it up. No good. Offensive rebound by Blue Arm. He'll give it to Colas. Over to McBride. Back to Luke. Luke, the Colas. Colas will put it up in 2 points by Jason Colas. It's now 39-28. 39-28. Stolen here by McBride. And he gets fouled.
Hey, I'm going to read a little public service announcement from the High School Activity Association. They remind you that high school activities are more than competition and performance. Each event is a crash course in cooperation, a test of dedication, and a character development. Students who participate in activities are more likely to enjoy greater academic achievement and learn lessons not taught in the classroom. High school activities are a winning part of a complete education. Back to you, Jess.
All right, so we had 2 falls on Chamberlain. One by Tegan Preeb, one by Dodge Knipling. That's Knipling's 2nd. Luke Wells will try to 3. It's up, no good. Rebound by number 2 for Chamberlain, Tegan Preeb. Tegan Preeb, the Maroon. Back to Riggs. Over to Tegan. To Dodge. Dodge will put the shot up. No good. Rebound by Joel Sazu. And he'll give it to Colas.
I think Coach Sazu told the boys, you better step up your rebounding, the way it looks so far.
Looks like they did just that. Blue arm over to Colas. Colas to Joel Sazu. He'll put the shot up. No good. And rebound. We'll give Dodge the rebound. 5:55 left to go in quarter number three. 39-28. Preeb. The Maroon. Back to Preeb. Over to the other Preeb. And I believe he gets fouled. Fouled by Luke Wells. I believe that's Luke's first. Seth Freeze with the ball. He'll give it to Preeb. Over to Maroon. Back to Preeb. The other Preeb. You know how you're at. Shots up, no good. Rebound by Sazu. Yeah, I'll get to that in a minute. You know how you know you're at McLaughlin. Did you ever do a McLaughlin game? There's always a taking life by eight, taking a life. 3 points here by Jaden McBride.
That'll be us next year. We go off to McLaughlin next year.
Yeah, that'll be the easy game. Taking a life to taking a life. Over to taking a life. Timeout by taking a life. 39-31. Seth Freeze with the shot. No good. And here comes Crow Creek. Colas will put it up. And he gets fouled. Looks like he's shooting two. Ball's at number 20. Riggs. I believe that's his third. Colas at the line. He'll be shooting two. First one's good. Shout out here to Angel Fellas, who's tuning in. She's even kicked back watching it on TV in the dark, too. Woo. Two for two for Colas. That'll inch. 39-33. Keegan Preeb. Over to Powers, who subbed in. Powers with the ball. He'll give it back to Tegan. Over to Dodge. Over to Seth. Seth will put it up, and he gets fouled. Ball's on Luke Wells, looks like. That's Luke's second. That'll send Seth Freeze to the free throw line for 1-1. First one's up and it's good.
Crow Creek's still in striking distance. That's a plus at this point. I don't know how the regular season game went at this point.
We lost by 20. 2 points by Seth Freeze. Quick update here. 45-44 Pine Ridge. 4:26 in the third. Over. Where are they playing again? Plankinton.
Mount Vernon, Plankinton.
Mount Vernon, Plankinton. We have a fall by Chamberlain. I didn't.
Yep.
Number
Powers.
One.
On Powers.
Powers, that's his second, I believe.
I've been impressed. Crow Creek's moving the ball a lot better than they did the first half right now.
Hey, shout out to Ray taking a live. I didn't know any taking lives were listening. My bad, bro. Rebound here by Dodge.
It was a sponsor scroller of the Take It Alive name.
Yeah. You gotta hunkah me, bro. You gotta hunkah. I want a star quote next time I'm up there. Hey. 41-33. Powers. Over to Preeb. Stolen here by Jaden McBride, and he'll put it up and 2 points. 41-35.
One thing I noticed with Crow Creek, McBride's been kind of a force many games when they need something to spark him a little bit.
Yeah, he's been that all-around guy, man. There's there's one of those things you don't know, and then boom, he'll steal the ball. And we're down by six.
He's the quiet one, unlike his mother. Oh, did I say that out loud? Oh,
did you say that?
Okay, we got a timeout. We'll go to commercial here. We'll be back in just a few minutes.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
All right, and we are back. Hey, let's have the camera guy kind of zoom in on some people.
No,
here.
Don't want to zoom. No zoom.
Okay, my bad.
Keep the zoom.
I was just joking around.
Yeah, you were joking.
Yeah, I was just joking around. You can't even zoom.
We'll be zooming at L and I next year, I think. Hopefully, yeah. I'll get the L and I board.
Oh, we got the. You got this one out at the pawn shop. Okay, all right, that's how it goes. Hey, Sioux Falls is checking in. They're cheering on the Chieftains. Joe Wells tuning in. He said he's listening to the Indian and the White Guy show.
Give us the money they have.
Stolen again by McBride. And he'll give it to Josiah Puan. 2 points. 41-37. We got past that 6-point lead. So look for a lot of good things to come. You know how last game was? It was down by so many points, and then boom. That's what I believe right now. That's what it feels like. See? Stolen. The blue arm. Then it's stolen again. Hey, I just jinxed it. Just jinxed it here. Stolen by Rich Marone. Elton Two Hawks, I believe, is tuned in. How are you, bro? Mount the bucket by Seth Freeze. He's kind of been cold all game. All quarter. All game, or what? I meant all quarter. Falls on number 25. Josiah Blue Arm. I believe that's his second
foul.
That's his second foul. Seth Freeze at the line to shoot the N1. That's good. Two minutes left to go in quarter number three, 44-37. We have a 7-point lead by Chamberlain. Sazu will drive it, and he'll put it up, and he gets fouled.
Balls are critical from here on out, making these free throws when they get to the line.
33, Marone. That's Marone's second. Sazu at the line to shoot two. No good. We got a sub coming in for Coal Creek, number 22, Rashawn Pease. Yeah, Elton is tuning in all the way from Central Housing.
Holy Toledo, Kansas.
That's a long way, man. Right next to... Can I say it on the air? Death Row?
Death Row, right by Death Row.
One for two by Sazu, 44-38.
I see Kelly Pazur from Chamberlain. Thank you for doing this broadcast tonight. I wish I could hear your jokes.
She can. We'll tag her. I know we can. I know this game will be recorded, so I'm going to be listening to it all day tomorrow.
You'll be replaying it on your radio show, won't you?
Yeah, I sure will. Stays here. It stays here, Chamberlain. Chamberlain basketball, 126. Left to go in quarter number three, 44-38. Seth Freeze with the Daku shot. He'll get his own rebound, and he'll put it up.
I see Tanya Marks is ratting me out to Geraldine.
Oh, Uh-oh. Luke Wells.
I don't think we had much fan agreement on that one.
I don't. Is that another one? 22, Pease.
Be on Pease, I think. Right now, free throws are critical in this game, it seems. Crow Creek's made one, I think, in the whole game, right?
Free throws can either get us back in it, or Chamberlain can make their lead bigger. Knipling with shooting two. He misses the first one. 1-for-2 here for Dodge Knipling. Danielle Dixon tuning in all the way from Chamberlain. Colas will put it up in 2 points. 45-41, 0-3 left to go in quarter number three.
I like this. I like the energy Crow Creek's putting out right now.
I love it, man.
That should be a charge.
That is a charge. Seth Freeze.
He sat in there and took it. One thing Chamberlain hasn't been used to all year is really being back on their heels.
Yeah, I know they've been blowing out teams left and right, but tonight we got a ball game. 45-40. Colas to Sazu, who tried a three. It's up, no good. Rebound, Dodge Knipling.
That young man can light on fire any time, though, so I wouldn't quit if I was him.
Yeah, he has the ability to put up 40 at will. Kind of like me, my old Tribal Hall days. Remember the Tribal Hall?
Yep, I thought maybe back on the slab or something, too.
. 51-56, Pine Ridge after three quarters.
Nice. Nice play by Sazu there.
Knocked out of bounds. It stays here.
Big, big play right here. 4 seconds on the shot clock, 9.4 on the clock. No bucket, but they're going to call the foul on Wells.
How many is that on him? Is that four?
It should be four on Mr. Wells. He's played one heck of a game. Hopefully he can continue to play it.
There's a couple of them calls that were kind of questionable, but that's why I'm right here, not chewing out refs.
The ref job is a thankless job.
Yes, it is. That's why I like to say, that's why I'm just an announcer. I'm not a ref. Thank God Mama didn't make me a ref. 2-for-2 here for Knipling. Shots up, no good.
And it's the end.
And that is the end of quarter number three, 47-40. So we're into for one heck of a fourth quarter here. And we'll get into our sponsors.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Running outdoors, you gotta take what nature gives you. We'd like to say we run when they don't. So we wanna give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run, when it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. We're gonna have products for you to get out there. You don't get better sitting on your butt not training. You gotta get out there and run.
At Under Armour, it's always about premium textiles. They need to perform, they need to be the best. The merging of hybrid textiles with naturals and new seaming and bonding and super sleek, modern, fast, futuristic designs, that's where we are really gonna turn it up a notch. If you look good and you feel good, you're gonna perform better.
All right, and we are back here. Quarter number four, 47-40. Chamberlain over Crow Creek. Sazu with the ball. He'll give it to Rayshawn Pease. He'll try the three. It's up, no good. Rebound by number 33, Rich Marone. Also, we have another 2 points here by Seth Freeze. 49-40. Jaden McBride will give it to Blue Arm. Back to McBride over to Rayshawn Pease. Rayshawn over to Colas. Colas to Rayshawn Pease. He'll give it to Joe Sazu. Sazu will spin, will put the shot up, and 2 points. Joe Sazu. ...49-42. Chamberlain with a 7-point lead. 7 minutes left to go. Key chalk ball by Sazu. Offensive rebound. And then finally, tripped over his own 2 feet here. Gives Chamberlain the basketball.
Every possession's critical now. We got to stop him.
Shots up, no good. Another offensive rebound by Chamberlain.
Looked like a push on that rebound.
He'll try another three. This time, defensive rebound. Joe Sazu.
Every possession's critical from here on out.
Sazu with the ball. He'll give it to Rayshawn Pease. Over to Blue Arm. Back to Sazu. He'll try the three.
Bingo. Oh.
Almost.
Come up.
Jump ball. They're calling it a jump ball. Possession arrow goes to Chamberlain. Well, we got it.
Joe Wells went ahead and told me they all ratted me out. Can you believe that, Jess?
I believe it. I believe it. They're from Crow Creek. Hey, I just kidding. Hey, we got a. You know, I did a radio show this morning, and then we had a caller from D.C. listening. He likes all his Paul jams, and somehow he found me here on this internet stream. So thank you to that Hasapa all the way from D.C. You know who you are. 5:44 left to go in the ball game. 49-42. We got a foul. Looks like Dodge Knipling will be shooting two. Ball's at number 22 for Crow Creek. Rayshawn Pease. That's his third. Knipling at the line to be shooting two. To be shooting two. Did I say to be shooting two? Yes, I did. First one's good. Sub coming in for Crow Creek, number 14, Kellen St. John, and 11, Luke Wells.
Got a score here for everybody. The number one team in the state so far, Madison, 67-30 over Hot Springs. They're the first one in the state tournament besides St. Thomas More. And then we got T as well, I should say. So we got three in the field set.
Two for two here for Dodge Knipling. 51-42. Stolen by Seth Freeze. And he gets fouled by Blue Arm. Count the bucket. Blue Arm's third. Seth at the line to shoot the N1. No good. Rebound
like
by Luke.
Thank Chamberlain AD Todd Palmer for these scores that keep coming to me.
St. John wide open. He'll try the three. Good. 53-45. 5:06 left to go. Shout out here to Kathy and Uncle Cheddar. All the way from Rapid, who tuning in. Falls on Colas. I believe that's his second. We're at team fall number 9, it looks like, for Crow Creek. Team fall number 6 for Chamberlain. Number 20, Riggs Preeb at the line, shooting two. First one is good. 65-44 update. Mount Vernon Plankinton over Pine Ridge. 3:40 left to go in the fourth. And it makes them both, I believe. 55-45, 10-point lead. Zazu will give it to Luke Wells. He'll try the shot. It's up. No good. Rebound by number 20.
We got a body down the floor. Looks like Mr. Zazu.
We have an injury.
Holding. Looks like a knee it's holding. It's not a good sign.
Looks like his knee.
While we have this going on, why don't we head to commercial for a quick second?
All right.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on!
First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
One.
All right, then. Looks like Joel Zazu is okay. He's walking off by himself. We're going to have the trainers take a look at him. 68-44. Quick update. Mount Vernon, Plankinton over Pine Ridge. A little over 3 minutes left to go. Shout out here, Corey Bishop Jr. Tylen Loudner listening or watching. From Mitchell.
True radio guy there, watching,
yeah.
Listening. Couldn't get her in your mind.
You know what? When I first got on the radio, that was one of the things that I said is that I got to watch myself because people are listening to me on the radio. I got to lose some weight.
I know. That's what I keep thinking now, yeah. That I'm doing these live streams.
Yeah. I got to lose some weight because people are watching me on the radio.
I'll probably just have a taco salad tonight at Taco John's.
4:30.
Bravo.
Graveling. Shout out here, Brenda Kirky.
And we got a runaway on the court.
Hey, whose kid is that? It's not, must be.
Is it a future chieftain?
Is that a, oh, well, okay, yeah, that's her kid. Okay, might know, that's her kid. Hey. How come everything happens when I'm doing something? Some kid has to run on the court or something. Look, another one. Almost. Luke Wells will get fouled.
Going to the line for two shots.
Seth Freeze with the foul. That's his second. Luke Wells will be shooting two. Real quick, shout out here to Sister Dawn tuning in from Sioux Falls.
Sioux Valley, 61. Dakota Valley, 55 into the third. Sioux Valley, a team we'll play next year, December 27th up there for the Swiftel Classic.
Nice. One for two for Luke. We got a good sign here. Joel Zazu, the third, back in for Crow Creek. It's now a 9-point lead for Chamberlain, 55-46.
It's a warrior mentality right there. True chieftain right there.
4 minutes, 10 seconds left to go in the bowl game. This is where it matters most here. 4 minutes left. And it's stolen here by Zazu. And it looked like he stepped on the line.
That's what they're saying, but we got some guys right on the line there that were really disputing that call. So we need to have the instant replay.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. 3:50 to go in the half. 55-46. Shot is up, no good.
Yeah,
it looks like we have a foul. Possibly a makeup call? Possibly a makeup call. I'll say it. I ain't scared.
I think we ought to get Gideon and Elijah. We should get them to give us a recap,
yeah,
of that play over there.
We'll have them do it in slow motion.
Yes.
Possibly makeup call here. That'll send 1-1.
The Zazu brothers, sitting over there watching their brother Billy Joe coach and watching this great game.
Chopper and Baby Joe.
Done a heck of a job with these Chieftains from LNI all the way till now. Kudos to him. I think one key that there's been with the Chieftains, though, in the last 2 years, they've had continuity with coaching.
Yeah.
And that hadn't been happening over many, many years there.
I believe Bijo has another year under contract for coaching.
I thought maybe they give him a 10-year contract.
Yeah, that's 3 years for now, and then go on from there. Count the bucket for Seth Freeze. Ball's on Blue Arm. I believe that's his fourth.
Yep, number four.
Jaron Estes coming in for Crow Creek.
He's another young man I've read a few times about where he must have had some breakout moments.
He's a 6'4 senior. Oh boy, man, he can shoot, man. When he's on, he is on, let me tell you that. And that's exactly what we need right now. Seth Freeze at the line, shooting the end one, and it is good. 58-46, 12-point lead, 3:16 left to go in the ball game. Luke Wild with the ball. He'll give it to Colas. Colas to Sazu. Sazu back to Colas. Colas has tried the three. It's up and it's good.
There we go. Now we got to get a stop.
8:49.
Need a stop every time here on.
We need pressure for these next 3 minutes. Non-stop. The boys got to give everything they have here if they want to go to state. They want to go to state. Now's the time to turn it on. Now's the time to pick everything up. Defense, rebounds, everything. Seth Freeze will put the ball up and no good. Rebound by number 34. Dodge Knipley. Take the Chamberlain lead back up to 11.
Kind of a late whistle.
Oh, he don't know.
I'm not supposed to be impartial, but I don't know about that call there.
He was gonna call something and then he changed his mind, so okay. No comment on that, I guess. That's a tough job. Like I said, refereeing is a tough job. Knipley for two. 62-49. We got 2 minutes left. 13-point lead. 3 points. Luke Wells. 10-point lead. 2 minutes left. 10-point lead. 2 minutes left. This is where we need to pick everything up here because Chamberlain's going to slow it down, take every little time they can off the clock here.
Yep, if they could run a 35-second clock, the game's going to be over a couple times here.
Foul on number 24, Jaron Estes.
That's 10 now, so it'll be a bonus now from here on out.
69-76, 48 seconds left. I believe Mount Vernon is over Pine Ridge. 69-67, 48 seconds left. .135 left to go in the ball game here. Crow Creek needs a miracle. I got to say it, man, because we can use all the help we can. Sazu with the offensive rebound, and he'll put it up in 2 points.
Had to put pressure on that ball. Full board now.
Timeout.
Timeout called. We'll go to a commercial here quick.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
And we are back here, 63-54, 1:20 left to go in the ball game. Quick update here on Mount Vernon, Pine Ridge, 72-76, 38.6 seconds left. Pine Ridge is down by four. I know T area beat Little Wound. If anyone's listening, anybody want to let me know on the White River game? I know we have a Crow Creek boy playing for White River. 1-18.
I got a note. Don't let me forget. I got to get a taco salad from Taco John's. The boss lady says a taco salad from Taco John's.
Ball's on Kellen.
Well, right now, free throws have been a critical element in the whole game. I think Chamberlain's probably shooting about 80 or 90% from the line compared to Crow Creek, probably at about 30, I think.
Yeah, they missed a lot of free throws. Two for two for Tegan Preeb. And we have a update here, 74-76. Mount Vernon, 19 seconds. Estes with the shot up, no good. Knipling with the rebound. Rich Marone, 1 minute left, 67-54. We got a 13-point lead by Chamberlain.
It's one thing I've seen with Crow Creek, though. They have never said, they never died in a game. They just, they keep going and going, and they keep coming at you at all angles, no matter what. That's something, that's credit to the coach, instilling that Chieftain pride back into them.
Yeah, you know, that's one thing that I noticed here. As far as the basketball program here, the past few years, I really want to publicly thank Billy Joel for bringing back that Chieftain pride back to Crow Creek. You know, it was lost for a while, but these past few years, you know, our Chieftain pride is really showing tonight.
Here we go again, another missed free throw. That's been the name of the game all night.
Ball on Joel Sazu. We got an update here. White River won big tonight. Shout out to White River. I believe they're going to state.
Going back to the state tournament again. Congratulations to Eldon Marshall and the crew.
Preeb. At the line to shoot two. First one's good. Blue arm. We sub it in.
There's my reply about getting the taco.
There we go, 40 seconds left. 69-54. It looks like Chamberlain will be going to state here.
Thank you to Dave Brushbreaker for that 76-40 White River score to us. Another one that gave us that.
Danny Sazu will give it to Jaron Estes. Jaron Estes will put it up, no good. Dodge Knippling. 18 seconds left.
One heck of a season, though, I will say that for Crow Creek. Jess, I want to thank you tonight, too. That really appreciate the opportunity to come up here and help you guys with the broadcast and for you to step in and help your team and your school out.
Yeah, it's been fun. It's been a good season here.
It's always a joy to come up and rep at Crow Creek for volleyball. I know Jana's
shout out here to Jana and Simon. They're tuning in. I don't know where they're at here, but 79-77, Mount Vernon. 6.9 seconds left.
Are they sitting down? Are they sitting down at the dark side, are they?
Yeah, they're at the dark side, somewhere at the dark side. 77-81, 6.9 seconds left between Mount Vernon and Pine Ridge. But you know, ladies and gentlemen, it's been one heck of a game here, one heck of a season here for our boys. You know, we had a lot of ups and downs, but, you know, we all stayed together. And we have four seniors that will be leaving us. Jaron Estes, Kellen St. John, Danny Sazu, and Rayshawn Pease are our only seniors. We have a lot of talent coming back next year. I know our girls, shout out to our girls. We have a lot of freshmen, seventh graders, eighth graders playing for our ladies Chieftains.
You got two, St. Francis the same way. You got two young teams coming up the ladder.
Yeah, so we got two young schools here that in the future. I know in the future our girls, Lady Chieftains will be in state. Our boys Chieftains will be in state. But it looks like that about wraps it up here.
You got any?
We have a final score also. Final score here. Chamberlain 71, Crow Creek 57. Also have a final score. Mount Vernon, Pine Ridge. Pine Ridge 77, Mount Vernon, Plankinton 81.
So right now we have five teams in the state tournament that we know of: Madison, T Area, St. Thomas More, Mount Vernon, Plankinton, and Chamberlain. You know, and talking to Rich Kroegel before I come down here today, you know, that was one of his biggest concerns is the speed and size of the Chamberlain team against Crow Creek. And he said they were going to have to play a flawless game, and that the free throws said a lot of it. And you know, they come out second half and started rebounding real well. So why don't we go to a commercial? We'll come back and wrap it up for the night. How's that sound?
All righty, let's do that.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Mic's on!
First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Running outdoors, you gotta take what nature gives you. We'd like to say we run when they don't. So we wanna give you products to be able to run when you don't think you should run, when it's pouring rain outside, it's snowing. We're gonna have products for you to get out there. You don't get better sitting on your butt not training. You gotta get out there and run.
At Under Armour, it's always about premium textiles. They need to perform, they need to be the best. The merging of hybrid textiles with naturals and new seaming and bonding and super sleek, modern, fast, futuristic designs, that's where we are really gonna turn it up a notch. If you look good and you feel good, you're gonna perform better.
All right, then we are back here. Once again, final score 71-56. Chamberlain over Crow Creek. Congratulations to Chamberlain. They are heading to state. Who else we have going in the state?
Now we got Sioux Valley was ahead of Dakota Valley, and I'm going to guess they probably will win that game. They've won pretty easily in their first-round region games. So you got Madison, Tyria, St. Thomas More, Mount Vernon, Plankton, Chamberlain. And then I would say Sioux Valley, and then we got a couple games we got to find out about.
All right, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 teams that punched their ticket into state, and I gotta call Sioux Falls and cancel my room. You know, like I said, I was so confident. You know, I'm a hardcore Chieftain fan through and through. You know, even if our boys only win like 3 games throughout the whole season, you know, I still believe our boys are going to make it to the state. And that's what we have here for our Crow Creek fans. I know our Chieftain pride is back. Our Chieftain pride is back, and we got a lot of good things left here. We got a lot of years, a lot of us know Crow Creek is a basketball program. And now our Lady Chieftains will be doing the same. I know we have about 3, 4, 5 years of good Lady Chieftain basketball. And that that about does it for me, though. You know, I gotta head back and want to thank you again, Mr. C. Want to thank St. Francis Indian Schools for helping us out here with the internet stream. I know we have a lot of viewers that couldn't make it at the game tonight. I know we were supposed to do stats here, but this is my first game.
His rookie game, and yeah. I'm usually just a producer, so
yeah.
I want to thank Nate Hislaw for giving me the chance to bring our system up for you guys, too, tonight. And Nate said he would pay for your rooms at the state tournament, though.
Okay, all right. Nate Hislaw said he'll take care of my rooms at state, even though I don't even want to go anymore.
Okay, well, that's a wrap. I want to thank you again, Jesse, and thank the Coal Creek School for letting us come up and help them. It was a great game, and I thank you all, and have a great night. Drive safe.
Opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment that you captured. Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now, the clock's run out.